friends, UpStreet Online is up and running, and I hope you are too. I'm Jean, and thanks for spending some time with us today. What we're talking about this month is a big deal, and we don't want to waste any time getting into it. So, let's go!
You stuck around? Fantastic. Listen, I am so pumped for this month because we're gonna get inside some really cool truths. I'm gonna help you learn some of these things because knowing more about what we believe helps us know more about God. And really, knowing more about God helps us have a really awesome relationship with Him. Like, what could be better than that? Now, I like discovering things, but I also like clues that help me in my discovery. And God gave us a verse in the Bible that is like the best clue in helping us know what we believe. Here it is. It's John 3:16, and it says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life." John 3:16. Now listen, one of Jesus's friends wrote this because he wanted the world to know something incredible about God. And here it is, "For God so loved the world." God loved. Those two words, God loved, changed the whole world. I mean, God loved tells us what God thinks of us, what God thinks of you. God loves you. God created the whole world, all the things in it, but God loves you. God loves you all the time, when you do all the right things and when you do things that are wrong. I mean, God loves you when you get mad, when you're happy, or when you're lonely. God loves you no matter what. God's love for us is one of the most important things that we believe. And we know God loves us, and we believe God loves us because of an amazing thing God did for you and for me and the whole world. So I want you to take a look at this water. It's dirty, isn't it? Like, this is not clean, and you and I, we do not want to drink this. But we all kind of look like this dirty water on the inside. We're not perfect. We don't do everything right all the time, right? I mean, we've all said words that have hurt others, or we haven't obeyed our parents, or we've been selfish when we should have been generous. All that stuff is called sin. And sin is really all the things that we say and things that we do that hurt God and hurt other people. And sin, makes us all yucky on the inside. And listen, you can believe this, we all sin. Not listening to your parents, lying, taking something that's not yours, being mean, calling someone names, it's all sin, and it's inside all of us. And the terrible thing about sin is there's no way we can get clean by ourselves. You just can't make it right. And that's a problem because this sin gets in the way of us having a relationship with God. And God did not like that at all. I mean, God loves us and wants us to have a relationship with Him. So God had a plan to take away our sin. And the plan was Jesus. We believe God loves because look at what this verse says. "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son." That's Jesus. God gave us Jesus to fix our sin problem. Jesus, he came to earth and he grew up and he told everyone how much God loved them. He didn't just tell them, he showed them. I mean, Jesus healed people who were sick. He fed people who were hungry, and he helped people. Jesus even forgave people of their sins. He could make all the wrong things right. I mean, Jesus could make us clean on the inside. And Jesus knew there was only one way that he could fix our sin problem forever. So Jesus, who was perfect, who never sinned, was going to die to take the punishment for our sins. God loved us so much that he gave us Jesus. Jesus was nailed to a cross and he died for us. And after he died, his friends buried Jesus in a cave and they rolled a huge stone over the entrance so that nobody could get in and nobody could get out. But get this, 3 days later, Jesus came back to life. Jesus died on the cross for us and then came back to life. Jesus proved that he was God's son and that he was bigger than death. And when he did that, God made it possible for our sins to be forgiven. Jesus took the punishment for our sins forever. God forgave you and he forgave me. No matter how hard we try, we're still gonna mess up, you know? We're all gonna do things that are wrong sometimes, but even when we do those things, we're still forgiven. Because God loved us so much that he gave us Jesus. These are two very important things you can believe are true about God, that God loved and God gave, and he did it for you. I mean, God loves you with a never-ending, unstoppable, forever love. So let's talk to God right now and let's thank him for giving us Jesus. God, thank you so much that you love us. Thank you that you gave us Jesus who died for our sins, and then he came back to life. And because of that, you, God, you forgive our sins. That's awesome. We love you so much. Amen.
Man, there is so much packed into that verse. It's like a serious truth bomb. And with something that important, we gotta make sure we do three things. You know what they are? We need to learn it, lock it, live it. And we've already spent some time learning about it, so now let's work to lock it in. When we lock in God's truth, it helps us remember it when we need it most. And the truth in this verse, we need to remember all the time. So let's jump right into locking it in. Here is our verse for the month, but it's got some blanks in it, and I'm gonna help you fill those in. And if you can't, that's okay. You're still learning it and locking it in by listening to us fill in the blanks. So don't sweat it if those blanks are making you sweat. Let's see if we can fill it in. Here we go. For God, that's right. For God, so we talked about it today. God did what? He loved. Yes, God loved. For God so loved the, who did he love? The world. Nice. For God so loved the world that he, this was the other thing God did. God loved and God gave, right? For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only, who did he give? He gave us Jesus, who is God's son. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that whoever, this is something we have to do. We have to, starts with a B, whoever believes. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have, this is something we get, it's eternal life, right? For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. And we can find all of this in the book of John in chapter 3, one more blank, 3:16. We did it! For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. John 3:16. Nice job, everyone. You'll get this verse in no time. Well, thanks for hanging out with us today. We're gonna be talking about this verse next week too, and diving into what that last part means. What does it mean to believe in Jesus? So be sure to check that out. See you guys.
Drop the beat.
I got a song that is burning inside my heart. I wanna tell everybody just who you are. Yeah, cause I once was lost, but now I'm found. was blind, but I see now. I believe in Jesus. I'm gonna sing it. I'm gonna sing and shout. I believe in Jesus. I'm singing. I believe you sent me free. Woo! Lift your hands and shout His name. Sing and dance the Jesus said. Came for us, gave His life on the cross.